Hello friends, in the last video we discussed about how to construct the molecular orbitals in pericyclic reactions. So in our syllabus we have, yes, the molecular orbitals of ethylene, 1,3-butadiene, 1,3,5-hexadiene, allyl radical, allyl cation, pentadienyl radical and pentadienyl cation. So today class we are going to discuss about how to draw the molecular orbitals of ethylene, 1,3-butadiene, and we are going to identify the symmetrical properties of the molecular orbitals and also electronic configuration and frontier molecular orbitals. So now the topic is ethylene, molecular orbitals of ethylene. So this is the structure of ethylene, which has two carbons. The two carbons are linked by pi bond. So here number of sp2 carbons are 2. One rule is there. Here the rule is, if the compound has n number of sp2 carbons, then it is going to produce n number of molecular orbitals. That means n number of sp2 carbons is equal to number of pi molecular orbitals. Here we have 2 sp2 carbon, that's why the ethylene has 2 molecular orbitals. So here the linear combination of 2 atomic orbitals undergoing to give 2 molecular orbitals. The 2 molecular orbitals are s, psi 1 and psi 2. In ethylene molecule we have 1 pi bond, therefore number of pi electrons in the ethylene is, so number of pi electrons, so 1 pi bond is there. So 1 pi bond, how you can define the bond? The bond is nothing but the sharing of 2 electrons. So therefore the bond, pi bond also share 2 electrons, therefore it has 2 electrons. So total number of electrons, nothing but pi electrons, are 2, because 1 pi bond is there. Now let's see the molecular orbitals. Here molecular orbital designation, nodes, sigma symmetry, C2 symmetry. So here 2 molecular orbitals are there, because linear combination of 2 atomic orbitals gives 2 molecular orbital. The designations psi 1, psi 2. So number of nodes in psi 1 molecular orbital, number of nodes is equal to nodes. Yes, what is the formula for nodes? So if psi n is the molecular orbital, the number of nodes equal to n minus 1. So therefore it has 0 nodes. And psi 2, 2 minus 1 is equal to 1 node is there. Okay, so see this, here in psi 1 there is no node, so plus orbital followed by plus orbital only. And here if it is plus, here obviously minus is there, and minus also followed by minus. That's why psi 1 molecular orbital does not have any nodes. Remember friends, in psi 1 molecular orbital, the top side all lobes are plus, bottom side all lobes are minus. Otherwise you can take reversely, all lobes are minus in the top, all lobes are plus in the bottom side. So come to the psi 2, the number of nodes in psi 2 molecular orbital is 1 according to this formula, n minus 1 is equal to 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. So the molecular orbital follow the symmetry. Remember, if a molecular orbital has odd number of nodes, one node should always come at middle of the orbital. So you can see one node is there, it is come in middle of the orbital. So this orbital always start with plus minus, so plus, so plus, here is the node is there, node means plus should followed by minus. Yes, and here you see minus followed by plus. So these are the molecular orbitals psi 1 and psi 2 of ethylene. So come to the symmetrical properties. So going to discuss about symmetrical properties, we have to recall once again. Psi n is molecular orbital if n is equal to odd. N is equal to odd. So like 1, 3, 5. So n is equal to odd, it is sigma symmetric, and C2, yes, asymmetric. And here, if n is equal to even, n is equal to even, like psi 2, psi 4, psi 6, the sigma is asymmetric and C2 is symmetric. So what is that? Psi n molecular orbital, n is equal to odd, sigma symmetric, n is equal to even, C2 symmetric. And come to psi 1, yes, it is a odd number. Odd number is sigma symmetric, and psi 2, this is a even number, sigma asymmetric. Come to C2, psi 1 is an odd number, C2 asymmetric, and C2 for psi 2 is symmetric. So this is about the symmetrical properties of ethylene molecular orbitals. Let's see the electronic configuration. Okay, so here molecular orbital, ground state electronic configuration. So psi 1, psi 2. So total number of electrons are 2. So each orbital can accommodate 2 electrons. So the 2 electrons filled into the psi 1 molecular orbital. Now we have to identify the molecular orbital. Before that, you have to see as the energy order. So from psi 1 to psi 2, the energy will increases. Here, what are the molecular orbital with electrons? Only psi 2 has electrons. In psi 1 has electrons, psi 2 does not have any electron. So therefore, obviously, psi 1 becomes homo. Right, here, what are the orbitals without electrons? Psi 2. Therefore, it becomes LUMO. Now, let's go to the first excited state electronic configuration. In first excited state electronic configuration, so what is happening? So, we are going to irradiate ethylene molecule with the light. This electron, yes, promotes to higher energy level. Yes. So now we have to identify HOMO and LUMO. So what are the molecular orbital with electrons? Psi 1 has electron. Psi 2 also has the electrons. In these two, which has the highest energy? Psi 2. That's why Psi 2 is called HOMO. Interestingly, for ethylene molecule, there is no LUMO. So let's write here thermal condition. Thermal condition electronic configuration, psi 1 has 2 electrons, psi 2 has 0 electrons, psi 1 2, psi 2 0. What is HOMO? Ground state HOMO is psi 1, yes, ground state LUMO is psi 2. So come to the photochemical condition or first excited state condition. The electronic configuration is psi 1 has 1 electron, psi 2 has 1 electron, psi 1 1, psi 2 1. What is HOMO? HOMO is psi 2. What is LUMO? There is no LUMO for ethylene molecule under photochemical condition. So friends, this is about the molecular orbitals of ethylene. Now, let's going to discuss about the molecular orbitals of 1,3-butadiene. So this is the structure of 1,3-butadiene. CH2 double bond CH, bond CH double bond CH2. All carbons are, yes, all carbons are so having pi bond nature. That means all carbons are undergoing the hybridization is sp2. So all carbons has sp2 hybridization. So therefore, the total sp2 hybridized carbons in 1,3-butadiene is 4. So therefore, so number of molecular orbitals equal to 4 because number of sp2 carbons is equal to number of pi molecular orbitals, that equal to 4 molecular orbitals are there. So linear combination of 4 atomic orbitals give 4 molecular orbitals. So what are those molecular orbitals? Yes, psi 1, psi 2, psi 3 and psi 4. So here it has 2 pi bonds. This is 1 pi bond and here it is second pi bond. So each pi bond is having 2 electrons. So number of pi bonds is equal to 2. 2 2s are, yes, 4 pi electrons are there. So totally pi electrons are 4. Okay, so now let us draw the molecular orbitals of 1,3-butadiene. Molecular orbital designation, S nodes, sigma symmetry and C2 symmetry. Yes, here the molecule has 4 sp2 carbons, that means 4 p atomic orbitals involving in linear combination. Therefore, each molecular orbital has 4 lobes. Yes, 2, 3, 4 lobes with 4 molecular orbitals. The designations are psi1, psi2, psi3, psi4. So, number of nodes is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. What is the rule? So, the number of nodes is equal to n minus 1. That's okay. Now, so in psi1, how many nodes are there? 0 nodes. 0 means there is no plus is not after minus, or minus is not after plus, always. So psi1 has the all lobes are plus at top side. Yes, all lobes are minus at bottom side. So psi2, number of nodes equal to 1. I already told you, when number of nodes are odd number like 1, 3, 5, one node should always come at middle of the orbital. So it is the middle of the orbital, therefore that one node come here. So here this is start with a plus. Okay, so psi3, it has two nodes. Molecular orbitals should follow symmetry. If you put one node here, if you put another node here, this is not asymmetric. So right here, to follow the symmetric condition, yes, if you write one node here, one node here, that will be symmetrical. And come to the psi4, so three nodes are there, so three is an odd number, therefore one node exactly come at middle of the orbital and the remaining two are come at these places. Okay, right here. So for psi2, yes, we start with plus in the first orbital. There is no node, so here also we have plus lobe. Yes, because no node is there. So see here, node is present, therefore it must be minus. So plus came at bottom. Here there is no node, therefore minus is followed by minus only. Yes, this is a psi2 molecular orbital. It come to the psi3. Yes, we start with plus, minus, and here is node is there, therefore it is followed by minus, and here no node is there, therefore minus. Node is there, therefore it is followed by plus. So for last orbital, plus minus are alternative. Yes, plus minus are alternative. So these are the molecular orbitals. So for the symmetrical properties, once again recall, psi n is a molecular orbital. If n is equal to odd number, n is equal to odd number, yes, then sigma symmetric, yes, C2 asymmetric. And here if n is equal to even, n is equal to even, now sigma symmetric, sorry, sigma asymmetric, C2 symmetric. Sorry, right, okay. So psi1 molecular orbital, where is psi1? Here psi1. What is psi1? 1 is odd, therefore sigma orbital is symmetric. Psi2, so psi2, 2 is a even, so sigma is asymmetric. Psi3, sigma symmetric because odd number. Psi4, 4 is even number, asymmetric. Come to the C2 symmetry. Psi1, 1 is, yes, odd number, therefore C2 is asymmetric. psi 2. 2 is a even number, therefore C2 is symmetric. Here is the condition, you just remember for a small trick. So C2, psi 2, C2, psi 2. Therefore psi 2 always symmetric. 2 is a even number, automatically 4 is symmetric, psi 6 is symmetric, like that you can remember easily. Psi 2, C2, symmetric. Psi 3 is odd number, therefore asymmetric. Psi 4, yes, symmetric. So these are the symmetrical properties of 1,3-butadiene molecular orbitals. Right. Let's see the electronic configuration of molecular orbitals. Molecular orbital, ground state electronic configuration, and psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, psi 4. Yes. Total number of pi electrons are 4. Each orbital can accommodate 2 electrons. So psi 1 filled with 2 electrons, psi 2 also filled with 2 electrons. So totally 4 electrons are filled into psi 1 and psi 2 molecular orbitals. Now, so this is the energy order. Yes, the energy will increase from psi 1 to psi 4. So psi 1, psi 2 has high energy, psi 3 has high energy than psi 2, psi 4 is most energetic orbital in 1,3-butadiene. So now, to identify HOMO and LUMO under thermal condition, nothing but ground state condition, yes, under thermal condition. So what are the orbitals with electrons? Psi 1, psi 2. In these two, which has high energy? Yes, psi 2 has a high energy. This has a high energy. Yes, that's why psi 2 becomes HOMO. That is clear, friends. So you have to see what are the molecular orbital with electrons and in those which has the high energy. So that becomes HOMO. For to identify LUMO, what are the orbitals with without electrons? So psi 3 is not having any electrons and psi 4 also not having any electrons. And in these two, which has lowest energy? Yes, psi 4 has highest energy, psi 3 has low energy. Now this becomes LUMO, lowest unoccupied molecular orbital. So come to here, first excited electronic configuration. Yes, here psi 1 has 2 electrons. So when 1,3-butadiene is irradiated with light, then this electron promotes to higher energy level. Yes. So now, to identify HOMO and LUMO, again you see the molecular orbitals with electrons. Yes, psi 2 has 2 electrons, sorry, psi 1 has 2 electrons, psi 2 has 1 electron, psi 3 also has 1 electron. In these three, which has highest energy? Yes, psi 3. Psi 3 has a high energy. Psi 3 has a energy. That's why the psi 3 is called HOMO. So there is only one orbital without electron that becomes a LUMO. So under thermal condition, the electronic configuration is psi 1 2, psi 2 2, psi 3 0, psi 4 0. Ground state HOMO is psi 2, ground state LUMO is psi 3. So first excited state electronic configuration is psi 2 2, sorry, psi 1 2, psi 2 1, psi 3 1, psi 4 0. First excited state HOMO is psi 3, first excited state LUMO is psi 4, friends. So this is about the molecular orbitals of 1,3-butadiene. We will see in the next class. Thank you, friends.